I want to start by telling you about my favorite cartoon growing up, which is SpongeBob SquarePants. Something to know about SpongeBob is that he really loves to catch jellyfish and clams, but he runs into a problem when doing so due to the uniformity of his net. Because of this, the smaller clams and jellyfish just go through the net and he cannot catch them. This gets SpongeBob really frustrated, and that frustration is actually felt by a lot of scientists all over the world that are trying to decontaminate our water sources. Like, just like the clams and the jellyfish, the contaminants come in different shapes and sizes, and they all come from different sources, like the pharmaceuticals we use every day, or the factories use dumping them on our lakes and rivers, or even natural ways like bacteria and viruses. That is why there is now one technology that can just remove it all. Of the current technologies out there, one that has been proven to be efficient is the use of membranes. Membranes are like a filter. Depending on the size of its pore, things will get removed or not. Anything bigger than the size of the pore will get retained, but anything smaller will just go through and stay with the water. Because of this, scientists have been making a lot of membranes with smaller and smaller pore size. But because of this, the cost and the technology needed to purify water go up and up. So we thought to ourselves, why don't we use a non-current technology that is cheap and efficient, and we use the tools at our reach to solve this problem. Tools like biological tools, like the DNA. The DNA that is in your body can serve this purpose. They can be engineered to bind to basically any molecule that you can think of, and they hold it into a complex that just doesn't let go. So my research as a chemist is, how do we use chemistry to attach this DNA to this membrane? After a lot of polymeric chemistries and attachments chemistries, we were able to create a system that does this, that has a DNA and a membrane, and that is able to remove toxins, that like BPA. That BPA that is in our plastics and in our water sources, we're able to remove it from really, really high concentrations all the way to under the level for human intake, according to the EPA. So this system does it all. It's able to remove small molecules with the help of the DNA, but it's also able to remove big contaminants like bacteria and viruses with the help of the membrane. So this system that we developed, the beauty of it all is that you can change this DNA. Let's say you wanna change that molecule and remove another thing. Just change that DNA, use my same system, and you are able to purify water. And this is how you get to an innovative water purification system. Thank you so much.